Okay, so in about 2 weeks, you're gonna actually be releasing the fifth studio album, Barefoot and Pregnant. Can you tell me about it?
Well, this time around, it's our fifth album. Our first three we released on independent labels, and then our last one, the self-titled album, we funded through Kickstarter and then self-released that. And it was amazing. So this time around, we decided that we were going to do another crowdsourcing thing, and we used Pledge Music, which is just a different, kind of a different platform for it that's, strictly for music. And so we set that up, and then we started writing and recording demos in our home studio. And I became very, very pregnant throughout the process. And then we took it into John Fields, our producer, and we finished up drums, and he put on some finishing touches and sparkles. And then Paul Hager, he mixed it up for us. But now we have an album.
And you just mentioned that you were working with producer John Fields again, and then you also had Stacy Jones playing drums for you this time around. How did you go about deciding on them to work with you on this album?
Well, John Fields is our go-to producer. He's pretty much a band member at this point. So he's done all of our records but one because our timing didn't line up on that one. But he's who we always work with. And he had actually been working with Stacy on a different project. And Stacy wanted to do it. So we were stoked because we're huge fans of Stacy's drumming and of his singing, of course, as well.
Out of the 13 songs that made it on the album, which one was your favorite to write and record?
I'm really, really loving Get Weird. It's kind of a different song for us. The drum beat is loosely based on Can't Hurry Love, the Scream song, and Lust for Life, Iggy Pop. Like, there's this drum beat that is just so, like, poppy. I don't really know how else to describe it. But we were like, all right, let's write a song and use that kind of drum beat. Lyrically, I love it. It's really fun to sing and play. We've actually been rehearsing because our record release party is next Thursday on the 20th, and it's a little tricky to play. Just the rhythm is a little bit different than, just straightforward rock and roll like we usually do. So I think right now that one's probably my favorite. I think recording Puppy Dog Eyes was probably my favorite because it was just like a lazy Saturday afternoon, and I was actually laying in my bed recording the vocals on just my live microphone. And when we went into the studio, it was like, all right, time to do vocals for real. And I went and I tried to beat my demo tape, and it just didn't seem to work. Like, it needed that sleepy bedroom sound, and so that's actually the final vocal take on that one. So that one has a little special piece of memory for me.
Have you decided on the single yet for the album?
We already did a video for Barefoot and Pregnant because we wanted to record it when I was really pregnant. And so we're gonna balance the title track and kind of the first single, but First World Anarchist is the first real single.
Are you gonna do a video for that song too?
Yeah, we are in, I think, probably this week, we're actually gonna start asking fans for submissions, because there are a lot of examples of how to be a first world anarchist in the song, and so we're gonna ask fans to send in video of them, breaking all the rules.
That would be cool.
Yeah, it seems like it'd just be a fun one to make. So we'll probably do a performance, and then we'll edit in fan footage.
Earlier,
Collaboration.
you had just mentioned that you were doing your album with Pledge Music, and I saw that you went way over your goal. It was about 200%.
Yeah. It kind of blew our minds because, when we sit down and you have to decide on the goal without really knowing what's going to happen. And so we kind of laid it out and we figured, all right, well, we can make a record with this much. And so, every additional pledge, I mean, it means that, you know, we have to ship something and they're actually buying a product. But, you know, any additional we've been able to put toward making lyric videos. So we're making a lyric video for every song on the record, like a real lyric video. And then we're able to put some money into advertising, and it's actually really, really helped us to be able to promote the release without, you know, delving into savings and that sort of thing. So it's such a cool platform. So the fans get to be involved from the start, and then, you know, now we can tell them, like, hey, because you guys are so awesome, you know, check on, you know, Spin, we're going to have a little ad running, and, you know, things like that, but are usually not something that a strictly independent band can do easily. And so our fans are the best. They're actually helping us put out the record the right way.
Next week you're doing your CD release show, and then you have a few other days. Is there a full tour in the works right now, or?
Well, we have a brand new baby, so we're kind of looking at doing things regionally. And so the idea is, you know, we're doing the record release party, and then we're going to go out to Texas for South by Southwest. So we'll do some Southwest dates, and then we're actually booking some Northeast dates. So we're going to fly out there and play like a week or week and a half of shows. And we're just going to kind of keep doing things like that regionally. And we're also looking at getting back to the UK in the fall. But it won't be like, you know, 8 weeks in a van driving around the country. We'll kind of target things around festivals or a good show. So,
if you could tour with anyone, who would it be?
I should really have an answer to this question, and I never do. Someone that we haven't toured with before. I would want to go out with Green Day. I think that would be really, really fun.
Is that would be your dream tour?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, if we could have our friends play, Bowling for Soup was there, and Prima Donna was there. Go Big Go, that would be a really, really good tour.
Yeah, that actually sounds like a really good lineup.
Doesn't that make sense? I think that'd be an awesome tour. Somebody should tell Green Day I thought of it.
Aren't they on hiatus right now?
What? I'm sorry.
They should come back from a hiatus and do that tour.
Yeah, I think you're right. You should send them a little note. Hey, we've got this great idea.
If you could have one superpower for a day, what would you use it for, and would it be for good or evil? Or what would it be, and would you use it for good and evil? Or evil?
Would having like a second body be kind of a superpower? Because I could really use that right now.
I guess that would...
I mean, definitely for good, whatever I picked. If I could really be a superpower or have superpower, I think I'd want to fly. And I would save all the kittens stuck in trees and, you know, help all the old ladies cross the road by just picking them up like a bird and dropping them on the other side.
That would be very cool.
Wouldn't it be awesome? And I'd go really fast.
Yeah, I think that I would, if I had a superpower, I'd want to fly too.
Man, wouldn't it be cool? Oh, it'd be so cool.
So, the band started about 10 years ago. What has been the most memorable experience thus far?
Oh, man. I think when we played in Dublin the last time, my parents had asked me where my favorite place to play was. And so I told them that, you know, I really, really love playing in Dublin. And so last time we went over there, they came to the show, and I got to bring my dad out on stage, and he talked to the crowd, and all the kids went crazy. And I think that that's probably the most memorable moment, because, you know, as much as my parents are supportive of what we do now, you know, it took a while to win them over. I think they're still kind of halfway there, but I think when he got to experience that for just a minute and see, you know, why we do this, it really, really meant a lot. And he had a blast, so I think he wants to move to Ireland now and be Bono's neighbor.
I can't think of what I wanted to say now. Sorry. Okay, is there anything you want to tell your fans?
Well, you should totally come to shows because we like to hang out. And, of course, we're the ones doing Twitter and Facebook. So anytime you want to talk to us on Instagram, all you got to do is send a little message. And we are here. And we like to know our fans. And go get that record if you haven't heard it yet. Because our pledgers already have it, but everybody else can get it the 25th. So I hope that they love it. I hope that they can't stop screaming along to it with the windows down.
Has all the stuff that you offered through the pledge music, is that sold out, or is there stuff?
Most of it sold out, but there's still a few things out there. So it's going to stay open until the 25th.
So your fans can go pick up more stuff before then?
Yep. Or new fans.
Okay, thank you so much.
You got it, Maureen.